IVM.
Hi.
You're
listening
to
IVM
Daily.
Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of IVM Daily. I am being given rigorous instructions by our sound engineer who is living out his last few days of singlehood. Very soon to be married. But he doesn't want to speak about it, so we'll not go there. So let's talk to the people who are with me in the studio. I have Karthik. I forgot your name for a second.
It's Mohan now.
Mohan?
Yeah.
Karthik Mohan?
Yeah.
Mohan Karthik? And Jaanam.
Hi.
Who's just Jaanam for now.
Yes.
Alright, so since these are the last few days of 2018, we sort of looking back at the year and talking about how the year treated us. So today's topic is unexpected things that happened to us in 2018. Essentially, this is one large ploy for Jaanam to tell a story. So we'll save that for the we'll let her go third. But me and Karthik Mohan have been roped into this episode as well. Hmm. So Karthik, what was the most unexpected thing that happened to you in 2018?
So I passed out from my master's. Like,
what was that? Unexpected.
that was really unexpected because I failed in internals.
Okay.
My first year.
So you became a college graduate this year?
Yeah.
Damn, okay. You're young. Oh, you fail your internals, huh, then?
This is your first
last
job?
This is not exactly my first job. This is, I have done my internship before. Hmm. And then I was working, for 4 months, as a freelance assistant director and all.
Okay.
Now I'm here. I got a job.
So what was more unexpected? You passing out or you getting a proper job?
I would say me passing.
Okay.
I had really low attendance.
Hmm.
So it was a bit difficult. The case was really difficult. Because I had my college really far away from my house.
Mm-hmm.
So I preferred not going to college.
Okay.
So when my dad was ki tu charity deke hai kya? Jo fees hai.
Did you intentionally apply to a college far away from you so you didn't have to attend?
No, I was throughout my childhood, I was in Navi Mumbai.
Hmm.
So I had a curiosity about bahar padhna kaisa hota. What's the difference between studying in Navi Mumbai and studying outside Navi Mumbai?
Hmm.
Where was your college?
It was in Andheri.
Okay.
So it is in Andheri.
Yeah.
So
Now your office is in Khar, which is not very far from Andheri, but you come to office most of the days.
Because there's motivation, right?
Oh, it's the
money.
What's the
motivation?
She said.
Wow. Would you be willing to say how much you're getting paid on the podcast?
No.
Okay.
Random question. But I mean, I agree with Karthik. When I was studying, I was like, wait, why am I putting in all this effort for marks? Like, I'd rather put in the effort for money.
Yeah.
And then
your parents did pay money to the college.
Let them pay, na?
Yeah, they paid.
It's their responsibility.
They paid, but I studied just enough to pass. I wouldn't.
Yeah.
Basically,
aisa nahi hai.
You know what we are sounding like? It's like IVM is full of people who are just like, "Arey, pass ho gaya." No, guys, we are very.
We have a dentist in the house.
Half dentist.
Case in point. Yeah.
IVM is a family of people who broken people who wanted to achieve big dreams. So they came at IVM. Karthik, you want to ask what's the most unexpected thing that happened in my life? Today I'm saying this year.
So what is it?
Put some effort, no. Ask the full question.
You're getting money for this, Karthik, not marks.
What is the most unexpected thing that happened?
I took a solo vacation this year.
When?
To Kochi in April.
Oh, I thought you were going to say mommy.
No. That I take every year. That's expected. Yeah, so
Kochi.
What's
there in Kochi?
Kochi has beaches, some really cool beaches.
Let's go to Goa.
I'm going in February. That's expected because my
friend that's unexpected for me.
What?
I made a trip to Goa.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You can't have all unexpected things, okay?
No, we planned this thing for 6 years and I still
6 remember. Years?
Yeah, it's a plan in the making. So after that, we had 16 plans which got cancelled. I still remember the number because I was the one who used to pitch in the plan, and it used to get cancelled. So finally, this is my first, like, I spent my money on a trip, so it feels great. Yeah, moving on, Abbas.
Yeah, it was a very well deserved break that I took. I actually, frankly, have never been on like a completely solo trip. I'm either with family or been with friends or someone. But I did everything from start to finish on my own, from booking the tickets to getting a place to stay to
how difficult
mapping
was that?
Out my entire this thing. And then I went to Bangalore for a week and did a week of gigs, stand-up gigs in Bangalore. So that was also pretty cool. Every single day, I think I was on stage. So that was pretty amazing.
This was back in April or something.
It was in
right?
April, yeah. And it was therapeutic for me because Bangalore is the place where I couldn't complete my dentistry. So going back to that city and getting to perform was great. So that was one unexpected
thing. How much did you spend on this trip?
A decent amount. I mean, my tickets, everything. I took 4 flights. All of the flights cost me around $8,000, and the staying and everything cost me, I think, around ₹20,000. Yeah.
Nice.
I didn't like eat any fancy place. Again, I was alone, so I didn't need to. I could like survive with a very basic this thing.
And you didn't have money.
Huh?
You didn't have money. Like you.
I didn't have money. Yes. So yeah,
you spent loads.
It was a budget vacation, but it was a nice vacation. I enjoyed it very much.
What is the best thing that happened to you in this trip?
The gigs, maybe.
Or what's the best realization or like revelation or enlightenment that
you can kind of survive? Like, so in Kochi, almost no one speaks Hindi.
Yeah.
Or sometimes they don't even speak English. So like buying small things from the market, also you had to like put in effort, but then ultimately they would understand what you're trying to say, or if you want to ask the way to somewhere. So the communication that you take for granted every day, I realize that even if someone doesn't know your language, you can still communicate with them and get thoughts across.
Okay. And what is the best food you ate during this trip?
Best food,
best
I
meal.
Ate. Like I said, I was on a budget, so it's not like I ate any grand.
It doesn't have to be grand.
There was this maybe it had to do with where I ate it, but I used to go to Fort Kochi, the beach in Fort Kochi, and eat a particular kulfi that the guy used to sell. It was not exactly kesar pista. It was some weird kulfi. I used to point at it and he used to give it to me. So that kulfi was the best thing.
I love how this whole story is sounding like a euphemism for anyway.
For sex? What? I had a kulfi on the beach, guys. I used to point to it. To give it to me.
Yeah.
Okay, and finally, the reason why we're doing this episode. Jaanam, what's the most unexpected thing that happened to you in 2018?
I think if you're a regular listener, you probably know I have 2 cats at home. I've had them for almost 2 years now. And when I went to adopt my cats, I was going with the intention of adopting one, but 2 happened. So I was like, cool, now I've had 2 cats.
How does 2 happen?
I went to Cat Cafe and the whole adoption process, like they sit down with you, they explain it. There's a whole manual they have and they tell you that, you know what, if you're going for adoption, we advise you take 2 instead of 1 because most pairs, cats come in pairs and they have like this bonding with each other.
Okay.
So even if you're like not at home, they can play with each other and have fun and whatever. So yeah, they don't get lonely. So we took 2. We were like, obviously like, and then last week I was in office around 8:30 in the evening. And I had a recording of Paisa Vaisa. So my host, Anupam Gupta, he came up and he comes and tells me that, Jaanam, there's a kitten below your office. I was like, okay. He can't move. So why don't you just go and have a look and see? So I went down and
Does Anupam know you're a cat enthusiast?
He knew, but he had forgotten I had two cats. Okay. I had mentioned it earlier, but I think he forgot. Mm. But he kind of had a feeling like I'm into cats. So I go down and I see there's this tiny ginger kitten sitting on the stairs and he can't move. He's like he's probably shivering, and I go near him and he's not even scared or anything. He's just not moving. So I pick him up and he's very weak and cold. So I put him on my shoulder and he just sits there and meows. And I bring him up. I brought him up inside the office. We gave him some water. And yeah, then I called Abbas up. I went down to look for food. And usually chemists have
cat
food. But both the medical stores below our office didn't have. So I called Abbas up. And I think he's the second... as in he's the only other cat person I know in the office. So I was like, what do we do? Plus his friend is a vet.
Yeah.
So
she's not a vet, she's a dog trainer, but she knows the network of vets because it has to do with her business.
So and then Abbas tells me that don't feed it anything, just directly take it to the vet. So I rush to the vet with the kitten, and the I explain it to them, this is what happened. I just found this kitten below my office, and just check him or her and tell me what's up. Also, I didn't know the gender of the cat, so they told me it's a he. And they asked me, what do you plan to do with it? I was I'm looking to give it up for adoption or fostering. Let's see whoever comes forward and is reliable, I'll give it to them. So I bring the kitten back to office after getting medicines and food and all. And I put up posts. I start I go all berserk and posting on Facebook groups, putting up stories, tags, sending WhatsApp messages to my friends and saying hey, this cat, I just rescued this kitten, and do you know anyone who will take it? Then they ask around, they forward this whatever pictures, and they're like, oh, so cute, so tiny. I'm like, yeah,
then Jaanam had an Instagram poll as well.
That was later. Came later. Then before that, I put up these posts saying, hey guys, I already have two cats at home and I cannot keep it. As much as I would love to keep it, I can't. I already have two. But nobody really came forward. And so I took it home that day, and in a matter of days, my mom gets attached to the kitten. And now I can't, I have to keep it, guys. I have three cats at home now, two big grown fat ones and one small kitten.
Have you introduced the small one to the big one?
You know what, we haven't, but today morning, my mom, my mom's kept the kitten in her room where she sleeps. So she was, she woke up in the morning, to go to the kitchen or the bathroom or something, and she shut the door immediately. She finished whatever she was doing. She came back, and in the hall, she saw that the kitten is out in the hall.
Okay.
And he is with Happy, my other cat. And both are... she didn't exactly describe what happened properly. She just said they were playing. I was like, are you sure they were playing? She was like, I think they probably smelt each other and were getting familiar and probably play fighting or something. I don't know what
betrayal the older cats must have made. Has been in this house for how long?
No, but they've been able to smell the cat for sure. They can hear when they move their litter.
Obviously,
and
they
all can, they can smell the cat, they can hear it, but they cannot introduce them face to face. But today a face off happened, and then my mom saw this, so she immediately picked up the youngest, the kitten, and took him back.
Have
in
you
the
named
room.
The kitten?
Not yet. I'm thinking of calling him Simba.
Okay.
But I think if I can find a better name, I will replace it with something else.
Should we open it out to the listeners? Listeners, if you have any name suggestions, please write in to us. You're just going to DM it to Jaanam anyway.
So. just slide into my DMs, people. Tell me. I put up a poll first saying the kitten is really small. It just, if I put him on my shoulder, he'll just sit there, won't move. So I took a picture and put it up, and I was like, should I keep it or should I give him up for adoption? And 89% of the people voted for keep. And the poll was pointless because by that time my mom had made up her mind that this kitten
just
is
just social media gimmicks.
Also, I want to add that my sister has been completely against this kitten being at home because she's like, oh, we already have two, there's more responsibility. And she's just losing her mind. And she told my mom that, you know what, please let's just give it up for adoption. And she's been insisting and kind of fighting with her. And my mom's telling her, you know what? I'm going to give you up for adoption.
This is what exactly happens when your parents get attached to your pet.
Yeah, and yeah. Like today morning I woke up, I'm getting ready and my mom is like, the kitten is very small, you can just lift it up with one hand. So my mom is like doing aeroplane with the kitten in the air. And she's like, Ale mera bachcha, Ale mera bachcha. And I'm like, oh my god, what have I done?
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So the most unexpected thing that happened to you was...
I got a third cat out of nowhere, it's just there now.
Nice. Alright, so clearly that story wins this round.
Obviously.
Do you think you're gonna get one more in 2019?
Please no. I see one abandoned, like this one was abandoned, man. So right. I had to do, so I felt responsible for it.
You
so
found
I did
it
something.
On the steps of the office. You couldn't just let it go.
And she just plugged Paisa Vaisa on the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, Anupam, apart from giving amazing financial advice, also brings joy into your life by pointing to abandoned animals who you can take as pets.
Yeah, and I want to say that when this, like the way this kitten was lying on the steps, right, it could easily be stepped on by anyone. Someone could have easily missed it and stepped on it. So I was like, no, I have to take it. And he's, yeah, so man, when I found him, he was such a docile, calm creature. And throughout the journey, when I took him from, I found like a cardboard box, I took him in there from office to home, and throughout, it was a bumpy ride, and he slept throughout the journey. And the moment he got home, like after an hour, we realized he's like a little monster. He doesn't stop jumping. He is so active and hyper, and I have scars all over my neck and hands and legs. Like,
well,
it's just,
I guess it was meant to be. Because when it reached Janam's house, he was like, yes, this is it.
Like.
Maybe it's a cold outside.
Probably. And he was really weak. He had not eaten in a while. So when I actually took him to the vet and the vet gave him food, he was eating like he's not eaten in days. So,
Nice. So that was our, those were our stories of what happened, unexpected things that happened to us in 2018. Tell us, what are your most unexpected things that happened in 2018, and we'll probably retweet them or read them out if you find them interesting. You can reach out to us on social media. We are at IVM Podcast on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. You can send your cat names to Jaanam on, where can one find you, Jaanam?
You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Jaanam Devan.
Karthik?
I am at Grow Up Mohan on Instagram and Twitter.
And my Twitter handle is at Abbas Momin. So we'll see you tomorrow on Christmas Day for another episode of IVM Daily. Till then, bye-bye.
Bye.
Advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.
Family businesses get a bad rap. At one time, they were looked down on for getting rich, for being too ambitious. Today, they're still looked down on, but for not being ambitious enough. Not agile enough, not modern enough, too traditional in their mindset. The biggest brands and business houses in the country started out as humble family businesses. It's the way India has done business. Join Sonu Basin in conversation with stalwarts of Indian family businesses on the Inheritors podcast series by Bloomberg Quint. Discuss the highs and lows, the needs and pressure points of building a business legacy that spans generations.